and Sorority Life at the University of Vermont. V. Vargas, coordinator of fraternity and sorority life at the University of Vermont. Graham Bashmadar, who is the graduate advisor of the University of Vermont, fraternity and sorority life. And then for support today, we have William Angelosi, who is the graduate assistant for fraternity and sorority life at SUNY Plattsburgh. Alan Zwick Dunney, who is the director of fraternity and sorority life at SUNY Plattsburgh. Jake Hines and Kelsey Henn, who are the incoming fraternal excellence initiative coordinators for the next academic year. And it's my privilege to present the 10th group for today, which is All That's Not Funny.
So our organization is All That's Not Funny, and I'm Robin Bailey, the current president.
I'm Miller Stute, new member educator and former president.
I'm Sabrina Martinez, the current vice president of programming.
I'm Madeline Canary, I'm the current vice president of risk management.
And I'm Danelle Sobey, I'm a new member of All That's Not Funny.
So we're the 5-5 chapter of All That's Not Funny. We are currently doing the 5-5 chapter by our national organization, which is the highest rating given by them. So referring to our mission statement, the mission of All That's Not Funny sorority is to inspire and support exemplary women dedicated to friendship, the lifelong commitment to All That's Not Funny, and building on the mission of our Jewish chapters. Our national values are appreciation and wisdom, and our local values are trust and sharing to our community. So in the application that you will have, as well as the rest of the presentation, we will show you how we embody our mission statement and our values in everyday life. We also, once we get our bid up until graduation, and even as alumni, we strive to embody our values and our mission statement and show how we have become exemplary women because of All That's Not Funny. So these are all of the goals that were set for the 2017-2018 academic year. These are all the ones that we have achieved or improved upon since putting them forward. So touching on increasing GPA, specifically utilizing Epsilon Friends, we implemented a new cheat sheet that allows the older member to give to the new member. And here, you put down your favorite professor, some classes you really enjoy, little tips and helpful advice to get you through your major. Also, looking at the Holocaust Remembrance Ceremony was put together by our faculty advisor, Lila Mahera, which was something we attended as an organization.
We also revamped our standards point system, so now, as sisters send their points in, send in what they do throughout the month. At the end of the month, our Vice President of Standards will calculate all the points and we have to make sure we maintain a minimum every month to remain active. Additionally, with these points, some are weighted more heavily, such as community service will be weighed more heavily than giving a ride to a sister. And then we also have Always Acting AA5, which is AAA. It's a chair position that sits under me, and they are there to help assist me monitoring social media and making sure that we always hold ourselves to a higher standard. One thing that all our sisters know is we're always wearing our letters no matter where we go and what we do. So we just want to make sure we embody our values in every given moment, every single day.
So additionally, although it wasn't a local goal, this was something that we nationals coordinated. So we had our first ever transition retreat with the new and the old executive board. So during this time, the old got to reflect on their term and provide insight and wisdom to the new executive board, as well as help the new goal set for the upcoming term and answer any questions they have. And I believe we have a sheet in front of you of the itinerary that was run through.
So President's Academy is something that myself and not already attended the year before I, and this is put on by our national organization and held in Washington, D.C. over a weekend. Here I was taught leadership skills, communication skills, how to work in a team, and really what All That's Not Funny represents and what we as members of All That's Not Funny represent by when we wear our letters, and even when we're not wearing letters, we are holding the values and everything that AA5 stands for.
So additionally, I had the opportunity to attend summer convention as well as an emerging leader with me. This was a 5-day convention, and during this time, it was just a time to celebrate AA5 as well as get new programming and philanthropy ideas, which was a great experience. And there's also a program that we implemented this semester called the CARE program, which we will talk about later on.
And we have been currently starting to host more programs that involve community involved, not only in Greek, but classroom community on issues that regard women. And one of our sisters, Shay, talked about attended Me Too bathroom talk, and I was talking about derogatory words used towards women. And she felt that as sisters, we could put on a program that catered more to what the talk was about and influenced more people. So we paired up with a new Zai Multicultural Sorority Incorporated, and we held this program. It was greatly beneficial, and I felt that we all learned something that day.
So as I mentioned before, I am a new member of Epsilon Phi. So during my new member education process, we called a mock election to
members, so I'm happy that we did that. We also have Alpha Epsilon and Phi friends, which Arnie mentioned before. They're also helpful to me because I made connections with those people individually, and they helped me with like academics and just personal advice and got me along the way. I just know that I have a strong support system behind me at all times, which is really important to me. And in addition to that, I also grew in areas like time management skills and communication skills, and also like becoming more responsible. So I'm really proud of this.
So one other thing we do strive within our active chapter here is to make sure our connections with our alumni and our parents are strong at all times. So with our parents, we have a Facebook page where we constantly update community service we're doing, Sister of the Week, Smarty of the Week, just so they know what's going on within our active chapter. Sometimes our sisters do get busy and they can't always talk to their parents, so this is a great way for them to stay involved. We normally do have a event in the spring semester. We actually had to push it back this year, which I'm gonna talk about in a second. So we will be having a barbecue next semester where our parents are gonna come up and hang out with all our sisters and kind of see the girls and the women that their daughters are associated with. And this semester is actually our 30th year from us being chartered on this campus. So we have a really big event that we're hosting for all our alumni that are coming back, around 150 to 180 past members. They are going to share their stories of what it was like when they were here, how they went through their member education process, and just give us stories and everything that they want to inform us about, and we're going to tell them about how our active chapter is running. But additionally, we have our philanthropy event, our annual pancake breakfast, that will be during this time, so they're able to actually support Shark Share in an organization that we hold very near and dear to our heart.
So our diversity is something that we pride ourselves on. This also incorporates three of our values, which is how our members are understanding, tolerant, and loving of each individual that they come across. Also, I'd like to point out that our national organization just passed a new policy regarding transgender individuals, so they will be able to become Alpha Epsilon Phi members.
This was a big year of programming where we're expanding what we do within the educational programs we put on, not only with our sisters, but with the community we're in. We have National Avenues, which stands for Advocating Vision, Encouraging, and Understanding, and Sisterhood. I used to be up there for three avenues. We have expanded to our member retreat, where we involve the members of the day to get in. Jewish Heritage, because we're a Jewish-based sorority, so we've been trying more and more to incorporate that with our sisters and learn where we came from. Social justice, so like I said, the Me Too, we also had a locker room talk with Diana Rupes Amanda, and education at home, so the health of our sisters, and that has been a great help with our faculty advisor, Elin O'Hara, because she has a master's in mental health.
So, besides our goals, here's just other things that we've implemented and new things that we've incorporated into Alpha Epsilon Phi throughout this previous year. So, the nomination and voting process was also previously changed, so now every sister has an opportunity to self-nominate herself for whatever position she hopes to uphold, so everyone has a fair opportunity to run and hold these positions. Additionally, we reinstalled our AFSP walk, which is the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention. So we sponsor this walk every spring. Unfortunately, last we could not, but it is back again this spring and is sponsored by our organization. Additionally, ISA delegate will now be incorporated into some executive boards meeting and discussions. The executive board felt that incorporating the ISA delegate and talking to our chapter regarding community-based issues with them was important to help think of ideas and different things like that. Additionally, we've gained our faculty advisor, Elin, who's been a great help for us. We have mental health days, and most importantly, through this past year, we've gained 18 new members to help carry our legacy.
Responsible for that activity, and just let them know Sister X is using Mental Health Day.
So it's just a way for them to come to me in confidentiality, more so they don't have to worry about any reprimanding or talking to from that chair position saying, you should be here for these reasons.
Can you tell me a little bit about how financial management shows up in your chapter?
Yeah, it goes in with dues, you know. We have a series of plans that sisters can use to regulate the costs, speaking on behalf of two sisters. For next semester, I know that the financial obligation is quite a lot to ask, so we have actually come up with a reduced payment plan and reduced responsibility for the organization to fit their needs.
Additionally, going off of that, we do have a fundraiser position. So this past semester, we had like a flower and seed fundraiser, so these proceeds can go towards anything that the sister would like, so any additional costs that may come up throughout the semester. Besides just financial dues, every other thing is optional.
I think we talked about some of the goals that you have met. Is there anything that maybe you haven't met that you're working on, or things that maybe you just didn't mention?
I know one of our goals was community service. Even though we haven't worked on it, I would like personally to work more towards that goal, incorporating more of our Jewish heritage, going to synagogues, and doing that kind of community service, as well as increasing the hours is something that has been talked about, because we currently have a 15-hour requirement and possibly pushing it to 20 hours is something that we're looking into. Also, we encourage our sisters to, you know, go above and beyond the 15 hours. I know Amanda and Molly over there they've gone abroad and done mission trips for their nursing students, and they've gone and volunteered their time there, which has gone above the 15 hours. Myself, I volunteered when I was studying abroad in Japan teaching English, so we really encourage our members to not only just hit the 15-hour requirement, but to go above and beyond, not only in our community, but in other countries as well.
And going off of that, I know that our community service chair actually has the idea of either going to the Fitzpatrick's Cancer Center and CBPH over here, and hanging out with patients that are going through chemotherapy and supporting their families, as well as possibly becoming pen pals with Jewish women specifically through Shara Sherritt, that are going through their breast cancer stages and all of those treatments.
And another thing I'd like to touch on is our GPA. So while GPA is a main goal and something we are striving to achieve, last semester we did have over 50% of our chapter receive either Dean's List or get inducted into an academic honor society, which I'm really happy about that. Additionally, for executive board positions, we do have a minimum GPA, although at the Leadership Development Showcase, they asked if maybe we wouldn't have that to not reprimand those sisters from holding those executive board and higher level positions. So actually, the scholarship chair has implemented a document they can fill out and basically advocate as to why they believe they can hold this position, and ultimately the executive board makes the decision from what they wrote to run for that position.
Will be provided to you at a later date. I'll be coming through June 11th, and we will be